I welcome some of you from your distractions. Some of you are distracted already. That is a black person for you. Why Africa is still the way it is, it's because of distraction. Africa is still written because we are not focused. A little distraction will take you backward. They know your weak points. That is why they continue using it against you. I'm talking about the politicians. They know your weak points. If it was white people that wanted to get freedom, believe me, they could have gotten it. They could have gotten it. They are focused. They are in unity. They are not scattered. These people agree. These people don't agree. White people are not like that. But it's only in Africa that they get distracted. They know that once they drop fish for you like a rat, you start feasting on the fish and you forget your problem. Distraction. That is why they continue giving you one cup of rice on every election. And the disadvantage of your distraction is that your children will have to suffer for all your distractions. Continue getting distracted. Continue getting distracted. This is the only reason why I still admire Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. For 5 years, more than 5 years, he has been broadcasting. Nothing will ever make him to be distracted. But we here, a little thing will start getting distracted. That is why they use it against us. I am not telling you not to be happy. You have all the right to be happy. Do whatever you want to do. But I'm telling you, at this point in time, we have gotten to a stage where we need zero distraction. I'm talking about Hausa, Yoruba and Igbos. We have gotten to the stage where we need zero. When I mean zero, zero distraction. Not even your child should distract you. But no, not in Africa. Not in Africa. Your distraction is when your children will suffer. Oh, that is what I said. Let me remind you. When you continue getting distracted, you are going, I'm telling you the truth, the suffering will go from generation to generation. No, 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 no. Black people are just like that. That is why my leader now began to continue talking about black people. And your reasoning on a wee way, it pays a lot. Why you guys are getting distracted? A lot of things is going on, happening in the country you so admire. I have a friend that said that for us to have a progressive Nigeria, that we're not supposed to be talking about Biafra. If we had elected credible people in government, now a few days ago, the senators, your lawmakers, your favorite senators, voted against electronic voting. Electronic voting means free and fair election in Nigeria, where everybody will go and cast their votes and elect whoever they want to be their governor or their senator. But your lawmakers said no to it. Do you know why they said no to that? Because they see you all as animals. They don't see you people as human beings. They don't see you as somebody that have rights to come and choose who will be your governor or senator. They decide your fate. And what do? You get distracted. As usual, you always get distracted. They said that they don't want electronic voting. They want that system of voting, that INEC Wuruwuru system of voting, where after voting, when you finish voting, you go back home and INEC will write the results. They will write who will be your governor and your senator. They like rigging elections in Nigeria. That is why they say no to electronic voting. What is their excuse for not agreeing to electronic voting? Because of electricity. And somebody like Ojo Zokalu, a governor of a state for 8 years and current senator in the Senate House, is telling us that his village does not have electricity and network. That is why he don't want electronic voting. Pwah! Shame on you. Africa will never ever survive this. Africa deserves to be wiped out of the surface of this earth. A senator said that the reason why they don't want electronic voting is because there is no electricity. Are you not ashamed of yourself? Are you not ashamed that you opened your mouth to say it publicly that you don't have electricity? Oh, Africa is supposed to be a desert. You people, all of you, supposed to be converted to zombies. You say you don't have electricity. That is why the people will not be given free and fair election. Why are you a senator? And most of your senators were absent because they are not in the Senate because of you. They are not making any law that will benefit. I continue telling you people this. I tell you people this, that, oh, you have a bunch of lunatics. You have a bunch of lunatics as your senators and governors. They said they will not agree to electronic voting. They don't want free and fair election. They want that kind of election where they will have to be using talks, where they will have to be using ballot snatching of ballot box. They want the kind of election where they will have to give you one cup of rice. They want that kind of election where they will still be giving you 200 naira so that you will vote for them because they know they don't have plans for electricity. They don't have plans for electricity. So, since Nigeria does not have electricity and will never have electricity, tell me how you will get credible candidates that will represent you. God forbid. God forbid. It's a painful thing that I am a black person. God forbid. So, these are the people that sit down and decide your fate. Ojo Zokalo, you were a governor for 8 years. And you are telling us that you don't have electricity in your village and network. Are you not ashamed of yourself? Are you not supposed to be ashamed of your existence? That you are not going to vote to electronic voting because your village does not have network. God forbid. To fear akwa. I am shedding tears in my heart. It pains me so much. How come? I'm telling you, we could have still been under colonial rule. The white people could have done better. This useless independence that they allow us to have in 1960 is not doing us any good. If it was a white man that is still the president of Nigeria, Nigeria could have been a better place. It could have just been a paradise. They gave us independence, believing that we have brain. They don't know that we don't know nothing. You guys don't know nothing. So you want them to continue the system, analog system of voting, rigging voting, stealing of ballot boxes, thuggery in elections. That is what you want. I'm telling you guys, nature will speak against you. It will happen. Okay, man. My anger is with the people. They have subjected you to the level of an animal. You don't have choice. You don't have voice. You don't condemn them. You don't say anything bad. You only look like a donkey, like a zombie, because you cannot take your phone and speak against those people for once. Speak against them. They are oppressing you. What you use your phone to do is to get distracted. You are scared so that they don't kill you. Are you alive like this? Are you guys living like this? You guys are walking dead already. They don't value your lives. Why not stand up for your rights for once? When will you people start having senses? That is why they have subjected all of you to beggars online. You have to go online and beg. They see the way you beg. Before you give your child food, you have to come and beg for one small giveaway. You will have to like people post, share, comment. Before you qualify to have 2,000 naira to feed your children. Do you think they don't see all these things? They watch your activities online and they know that you guys are beggars. And you cannot stand for your rights. And they are going to oppress you in 2023 election if there is anything called Nigeria by then. Where will you people start having your senses with you? They see the way you people beg. Do you know the level of damage these people cost you? Before you can take your child to a hospital, you have to come online to beg in a giveaway post. And before you get 2,000 naira to go and treat your child, you have to share a post, like a post, comment on the post, whether you like the post or not, before you take your child to the hospital. That is a damage, serious damage. In a working system, in a good environment, when your child is not feeling fine, what you need to do is to press emergency. They will take your child and treat your child because your child is a citizen of a country. But they don't make provision for children. They don't make provision for mothers. They don't make provision for pregnant women. That is why you guys are still suffering. That is why Africa is still backward. And it makes me cry. It makes me cry. Esther said, if I die, I die. If I perish, I perish. I have gotten to a level in my life where I don't care what happens next. Why are you people like this? Why is Africa like this? Why is your mentality like this? You take your phone and you're doing nonsense. You are doing rubbish as far as I'm concerned. And they continue oppressing you. That is why our people are traveling abroad, getting good life, Do you know why people are traveling abroad? Because there is okay. Because Africa is rubbish. Africa is dead. And it makes me angry. They have subjected all of you to nothing. And you're comfortable. That is why Nnamdi Kanu has been shouting. Many people that are coming out to fight for your freedom, most of them are very comfortable. But they see what is going to happen to you. That is why they are calling. And you that they are oppressing, you are not concerned. What you know how to do is to be begging. For how long will you beg? Your children don't have jobs. And the child that you have, you are pregnant with now, will never be employed in Nigerian government. Nigerian government does not have plans for all of you. Why won't you all reason for once? They don't have plans for you. Your children will continue suffering. You will never have electricity. That is why they don't want to talk about electronic voting. Because they know, even in 10,000 years to come, Nigeria will never have electricity. And some people are telling me, we don't want to separate. Let us stay together. Stay together for what? Tell me. Frederick Lord Lugar came and brought us together. Before Frederick Lord Lugard came in 1914 to join all of us together, where were we? Where were our ancestors? Where were the Igbos? Where were the Yorubas? Where were the Hausas? Weren't we existing? Weren't we living normal? When he joined us together, he said, after 100 years, you people can decide your fate. You can decide to stay or not to stay. Because he knew that we don't have the same language. We don't have the same value system. We don't have the same ideology. We don't worship the same God. We don't have the same reasoning. That is why he said, we have all the rights to disintegrate after 100 years of existence. And one idiot is telling me that we don't have right to talk about secession. Are you normal? Are you okay? Why are you people like this? Posterity will never be kind to you people. You guys don't think about the children that are coming. You're only interested in yourself. Stop getting distracted. Your children will suffer for your distraction. That is what I'm telling you. What are you doing with your phone? Don't you know there is power in numbers? There is power in numbers. Those governors and senators, they are not up to 2 million population, but Nigeria has over 200 million. And the people agitating for their freedom are over 100 million people. So don't you think that 100 million will definitely supersede 2 million? Because they have police and army. Come out first. Speak against them. Let the international community know that all of us are collectively speaking in any way you can. Whether you're saying it on your phone, you're coming out on the street, wherever you are doing. The point is that they know that these people are tired. Not one set of people are jubilating. The other set of people are smiling. And they are confused. What you are doing is creating confusion. And the other people are antagonizing the other ones. That is confusion. When you continue like this, Africa will never ever change. That is what I said, let me tell you. Martin Luther King, wherever he is in his grave, will be crying because I know, even though he fought for Africa, he fought for South Africa, but he also had Nigeria in mind. He did not just fight for South Africa, but he knew that if he was alive, he would have fought for everybody. But you people don't deserve it. Nnamdi Kanu is in custody. You have to act now.